Look at the accompanying table. Find P of negative 4, P of 5, and P of 1. And then in part B, for what value or values of n does P of n equal to? Well, in order to answer this question, we need to understand function notation. When we have y is equal to f of x, f is the name of the function, x is the input, and y is the output. Now, in this particular problem, we don't have y, f, and x. We have n and p of n. So what we need to understand is what is the input, what is the output, and what is the name? Well, p is the name of the function, n is the input, and p of n is the output. So when we're asked to find p of negative 4, what we're asked to do is find the output when the input is negative 4. So we're going to look for negative 4 in the input row. The input row is the first row. We'll find negative 4, and we'll be looking for the corresponding output. Similarly, for p of 5, we'll be looking for 5 is an input, and then writing down the corresponding output. And for p of 1, we'll locate 1 in the input row, and we'll be looking for the corresponding output. So p of negative 4, we have negative 4 is the input, 0.063 is the output. So that will be our answer for p of negative 4. P of 5, 2 is the output. For 5, 32 is the output. So as we write down our answers, what is p of negative 4? P of negative 4 is 0.063. What is p of 5? P of 5 is equal to 32. And what is p of 1? P of 1 is equal to 2. As we move on to part B, it says, for what value or values of n does p of n equal to? Well, this time, instead of being given the input, we're given the output. P of n is the output, and that number is 2. So we want to locate 2 in the output column, which we've already done, and we want to write down what is the corresponding input. Well, the corresponding input is the number 1. So n is equal to 1.